Bright lights, camera, action, living in a dream.
A coach, the city of Philadelphia is one of rich history and passion, and you can always count on the latter when you step inside Lincoln Financial Field. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Cleveland Browns and the Philadelphia Eagles. The final playoff push is upon us. It's week 12 of the NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports.
Get ready! Get ready! Get ready!
Take a shot right away, and that's caught inside the 35. A big play there on the first play of the game, 45 yards. Well, how about a deep ball on the first play from scrimmage, putting that secondary on notice.
Brandon, all I remember when I was a player is that we always took a test the night before the game about teams' tendencies and what they plan to do. I'm not sure we think deep ball right out of the gate and putting us back on our heels.
That'll move the sticks for the Browns, a gain of 12.
And there we see an early burst that makes him one of the leading rushers in the league.
Well, I want you to know, I listened to you yesterday when we were watching film. You said write down the word vision for him. It was on display there, wasn't it?
It certainly was, because he allows the blocks to set up in front of him. And if that continues, it'll be a long afternoon for those guys trying to play some defense.
It's a loss of four on the first down play.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know. You know better than I. He has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete.
Defensively here, you're facing a top five team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout. And that means your offense has to keep pace.
Third and long for Mayfield. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jamal Adams. And he'll take it all the way up near the 30-yard line. Landry, the intended target. They were ball hawks last week. They had a trio of interceptions on defense. In the first drive, they pick up right where they left off.
They're creating quite a reputation for themselves, aren't they? And sometimes what happens is, when they know that the defense can take the ball away as they saw the previous week, now you try too hard to not let them take it away, and you force yourself into errors. They've intimidated them in a sense and gotten the ball from them.
I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. I'm coming after you. Alert flare. Alert flare. 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 Watch out. Watch out. Watch out. Watch out.
The former second-round pick, this is Joe Mixon. He finds an opening past the 40. And he'll take this down to the 40-yard line. He's able to rip off 32 on that one. It's a first down.
Boy, he does it at a high level, doesn't he? Because when I watch him, I think of his vision. Straight ahead, peripheral. Also has that sense of where holes are going to be before they actually open. I think that helps set him apart from many of the other backs in the league.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10.
Check 13. Kill, 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 kill.
Four, kill, kill.
Pick
the edge. Go, go. Here's Wentz to throw. He gets this in the hands of Mixon. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off because they took it away, right? So now you've got them back on their heels a little bit. Now go down, put a touchdown on them. Look out. You've won the mental battle early in the
game. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line.
And they're picking up right where they left off with the shutout that they pitched last week. A huge part of that, this pass rush. They know how to get after people.
Offensively, good luck finding some answers right now. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Now wins. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Used to have a coach who used to tell us all the time, those scouting reports aren't just to use up paper, guys. Well, nowadays, you know, we're watching a computer screen, right? They scouted this team very well. Know that they like to use the running backs in the passing game. They covered that play successfully.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Wentz. And that is incomplete. Denzel Ward right there in coverage to get the hand in.
Not only was the call spot on, how about the execution of that defense right there? Zone was absolutely locked up tight. He was trying to force it in there on third down.
But if there's a time to force it, he felt like he needed to make a play, right?
Yeah, exactly right. Third down, you got to try and find something. There's nothing available there for him. Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
The Browns drive about to get started. And, you know, certainly a lot of football left to be played. We're not into December yet. But right now where we stand, they're first place in their division. Looking good, looking to be a threat come January.
And let's think about what every team has in their goals, all right? Number one goal is what? Make the playoffs. Number two goal is win your division. Number three goal, and the biggest goal, I think, is to be the highest seed possible that you can be heading into the playoffs so that you can have as many home games as possible to try and get you to the Super Bowl.
And right now, fighting for every win possible to try to at least secure home field for the wild card and or divisional round. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. That's good for a Cleveland first down, an 11-yard pickup. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On the run, this is Hunt. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. Try to throw here. Mayfield, he's going to take a shot for the end zone. And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Antonio Callaway, his fifth touchdown now on the year. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken at his four. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line.
The Eagles take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs, so they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smell. And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. The D-tackle Sheldon Richardson came barreling in for the sack.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you do in a big way. And what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
He finds back a complete. And they get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A big gain of 28 as the drive continues. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 25-yard line. To throw is Wentz. He finds his target, Beckham. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. 17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Seems as if the passing attack starting to heat up a little bit here in the second quarter.
You can sense and you can see the momentum. Because now they're reading their patterns downfield, they're understanding the coverages, and they're finding the open holes in the defense.
Now Wentz again. And that's going to be caught for an Eagles touchdown. John Ross with touchdown number 8 on the year. As they are now on the board here in the first half. Hauschka with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This is taken at his 4. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive.
It's caught inside the 25, and all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Antonio Callaway with his second touchdown here in this first half, and the Browns have taken the lead. Well, that's a heck of a response to regain the lead after we had seen the touchdown to tie the game.
I would say what we just saw there was a great amount of poise because typically when teams tie the game up, it's a little bit of a, how would you say, you kind of take a step back and have to get yourself regrouped. They regrouped in a hurry, didn't they? They attacked back after they'd been tied.
And in a big way, that was a statement long touchdown. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They trail a one-score deficit 14-7 as they come up first and 10. Here's Joe Mixon as they start on the ground. 10 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Now, that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 41-yard line. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Throwing is Wentz. And incomplete there, almost picked off. That's one you maybe expect your roaming free safety to come up with. But it's second down. Here now is second and 10, again from the 41. Now Joe Mixon. He's got the first down here inside the 30. And he's finally down at the 21-yard line. That one, a gain of 20 in a first down. Wentz now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked up by Denzel Ward.
Well, I get what he was trying to do. He was moving to his right and trying to shift the coverage, but instead he shifted the coverage also to the right and threw right into it for an interception.
The Browns drive about to get started. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, to see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. On first down, they go right back to Hunt. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And that'll make this a second and 13.
180.
Okay, just like that.
McCaffrey on the counter. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes. Earlier this half, you were wondering how the defense was going to handle him defensively. Were they going to bottle him up at different levels, so to speak, is what you said. What have you seen so far?
Well, I think they've been absolutely terrific because it feels like on every play, if we were watching this in the film room, when he clicked off the film or stopped it, you would see 11 shirts of that same color right there in the frame trying to tackle him. That's what you're looking for.
Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning, hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play, and the officials are instructed. If there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down.
Let's go! Go.
Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate. Of course, they'd like to forget the ending, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, that does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20.
Right here.
Wentz into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy territory. On first down, they'll run with Hunt. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. Second and 13, Mayfield. He's going to look deep down the field. Now that'll be tipped in it. And I do believe this is going to wind up a safety. It is. It's a safety. How about that for a wacky play? Wow, what a disaster. You talk about a guy making a good play on the interception and then just trying to be too cute on the return.
It almost felt like his own gyroscope really got out of whack, didn't it? Going backwards into your own end zone after such a great play. Totally disoriented and gave up 2 points for his team.
And remember, following the safety, you give the football up as well. And they free kick it from the 20 now. Here's Austin.
Let's go. Let's do this.
The Browns drive about to get started. And two picks thrown here in this first half alone. We'll see how that affects it.
Can't wait to see where his confidence is, because the great ones, they'll throw four or five picks, and while it'll hurt their team, it won't hurt their confidence. They'll think something was just wrong with the ball or the wind or something was funny. It's never about them. That's how they stay so into the moment and into the game.
From the 40 now on second down, Mayfield. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts, as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10.
Hey, check Mike 27. Check Mike 27.
Watch. Hey, alert, 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 alert.
Check, 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 check.
Watch out.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Mayfield. Oh, the pressure too great, and he goes down once more. Khalil Mack, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Enough takes a star to have a good drive, quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
No, now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. Here's Hunt. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
That didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Here's Britton Colquitt now as he'll kick it away for the second time. First kick, 47. This one looks good as well. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do, or I guess don't do, on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more, it's who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
Hey, Echo!
Throwing on first is Wentz. And complete to Zach Ertz. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. The Eagles will take their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33.
Go, go. I'm bringing it to you.
Working from the gun, Wentz. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Logan. And he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down. Wentz now 9 of 15 throwing the ball, 60%, and it's first and 10.
List 5-7.
Hey,
Delta.
You think you won't get this?
Wentz to throw again. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Odell Beckham as the first half is winding down, as they have now chopped this lead down to three. Hauschka adds the extra point, and the lead is down to two. So the lead shaved to two now as the kickoff is away. This will be fielded at the eight. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. Time for a final kneel down or a safe run, and then they can head to the locker room with a lead.
Yeah, or they can even run a screen. You know, something they feel is somewhat safe that might actually pop and turn into a big play. That's what you usually run in this situation.
Or go four verticals because why not?
Because you're feeling it, right? You're just feeling it.
So we have reached halftime here in a tight two-point contest. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This will be fielded at the six. They'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance? And down he goes. They bring down Wentz on the sack. Give the sack to Lorenzo Carter.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Well, they're in some hot water now after that sack. It's second and 21. It's caught by OBJ. Weaving through traffic, and now he's free. And he'll take this into the end zone. Now, hold on here. We do have a flag down. So let's see what this is about. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter.
Here we go, here we go. 180!
All day.
46 down, man, 5-4.
Hey, Charlie.
50's a mic. Big stop, G. Big stop, let's go. Mike's 50.
Hey, we're good.
Now Wentz throwing on second down. Going deep downfield for... He's got a man complete. The 30. 10. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Three touchdown passes now for Carson Wentz. And once again, the Eagles are back out in front. And I think it's safe to say we won't call many touchdown passes longer than that this year, partner.
No, I would agree with that totally. And right now, you're looking at an offensive coordinator. Conservative would not go next to his name. Risk taker, definitely, because he valued the opportunity to create a big play against what could have been disaster if they end up getting sacked or fumbling the ball in the shadow of their own goal line.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
Come on, baby. Let's go!
The Browns drive about to get started. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Well, the first play of the drive, loss four. Now they'll look to move it forward here. here on second and 14. To throw, Mayfield. Buying time to his left. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down.
Hey, Haywood!
Here's Mayfield. Ebron's got it. A good pickup there for the Browns, 15 yards.
Partner, it's a lot of fun watching the NFL now, isn't it? Because when the big fella runs routes, it used to be when we were kids, he'd run about three different routes, and that was it. Now he can run anything and catch the balls we just saw there.
That's going to be a long day.
Hey, run.
King.
Hey, orbit.
Hurry.
On first and 10, Mayfield. He's going to wind up and air it out. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jamal Adams.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
Kill.
30. Lion.
They'll try to get the run game going. This is Mixon. Jonathan Jones there to make the stop.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now, meanwhile, here's a second down throw that's knocked away and incomplete. He was looking for John Ross that time. But now it'll be third down.
And 8 yards to go.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a third and 8.
Hey, high 7.
Shotgun now for Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. He had the touchdown earlier. This one's going to get him a first down. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there.
Here we go. Waiting!
Hey,
Lou.
After the penalty, it's Mixon. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Great 15.
On second and 15 now. Wentz, nowhere to escape, and he goes down.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And that'll wind up incomplete. Bold play call there. Now it's fourth down.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively.
Get ready.
The Browns drive about to get started.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here.
Got out of the pocket. Didn't look like he had anybody open, Charles, so just gets rid of it.
And a good play by him. If no one's open and you don't have a running lane that you want to take, make the right choice. Get rid of it. Live to fight another down.
They'll run with Hunt on second down. And not a whole lot to speak of there, as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on third and a tough nine.
And it's third down.
180.
Working out of the gun, Mayfield. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Robert Alford. And they will take over at the 29-yard line. Trying to get it to Landry there.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
Five.
50, Mike's 50.
Let's go.
Mike 50.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Ronald Darby. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. The Browns drive about to get started. They are looking to make a bit of a 180. They are sputtering right now.
And frankly, I think it's time to call your playmakers together and say, all right, guys, we're going to lean on you through this patch. We need you to get us back on track and get us going in the right direction. So you're calling plays geared to them. Not necessarily what you look at your plays, oh, this hurts the defense. I want the ball in the hands of X, Y, and Z and see if we can move forward.
So don't get too cute. Go to the playmakers. So that play much needed there as they're all the way up near the 40 for a first and 10. Mayfield gives this one to Hunt. And a 5-yard gain gets him to the 42.
Second and five at the 42-yard line.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. And not much there at all. Maybe a yard up to the 43. 5 yards on first down, but now just a 1-yard pickup there on second. In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it's going to leave them with a fourth down. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
Hey, alert, 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 alert.
Mayfield to throw for it on fourth. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a gain of 10, and the Browns are going to get a first down. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10.
King. Regular. Bravo.
Mayfield now. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And that's going to be caught for a Browns touchdown. A big play there. With a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Browns have retaken the lead. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come.
Let's go.
From the shotgun, it's Mayfield toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, that decision to me was all about pulling up the chart. You know, that beautiful chart that tells you when to go for two, when to go for
chart.
One. I do love it. It helps you with your decision making during heated times. And just look at it right here in this point of the game. Go for two. Try to make it a field goal difference.
But now just up one makes the rest of this fourth quarter a little more interesting.
Yeah, they followed the chart. They just didn't get the 2 points on the board, did they?
Nope.
The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Maybe a good spot to take a shot. Here, second and a yard from the 34. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Wentz gonna throw. Got a man. It's Arcega Whiteside. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. Wentz now 6 for 6 since coming back out of the locker room. It's first and 10. Now Mixon. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
We ain't beginning to turn you up. Don't get nervous.
On second and 9, Wentz. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
One of the bigger plays in the game thus far, and the crowd getting into it as we come up on a big third down.
Hey, Alpha!
58, 58, 58.
Kill, kill.
From the gun, it's Wentz. He finds Beckham, complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. And a nice gain of 21 yards. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Mixon with a first down carry. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads. Bowled over a few people. Look at that one. Right up the gut.
So up through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now.
Shit, shit. Shit. Watch the ship. Watch the ship. Hey, hey. Watch the ship. Watch the ship.
Again, it's Mixon. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4 yard pickup leaves him with third and one. So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They face a critical third down now, needing a score here in the late going. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 14 yards there and an Eagle first down.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Back
25.
Lead 5-3. Lead 5-3.
Check three.
So that'll back him up 5.
Come on now, let's go.
Now they need 15 yards on this series after the delay of game. First and 15. They'll run with Mixon, and he'll take this inside the 20 and down to the 18. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Wentz to throw. And he finds his tight end. It's Ertz. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. The Eagle passing game looking good on this drive. It's a first down. They come out here in the eye. And the question now, how do they want to work the clock here on first and goal? A field goal would give them the late lead. Here's a run with Mixon, and they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the 1. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call, mark off the 5, and keep it moving.
So the ball's moved to about the 1 after the penalty, first and goal. Mixon trying to punch it in, and he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Joe Mixon. With time running out, and they have taken the lead here in the final minute.
How many people are watching this one right here who gave up? Because that score, they might want to try and rush back into this stadium.
Yeah, what looks like is going to be the game-deciding score, although a little bit of time left, so you can't count your chickens before they're hatched.
Well, they better come back.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started. Critical condition here, obviously. Got to hope to get something quick right and then maybe take that shot deep.
And once they do take the big shot, you've got to worry on defense. Of course, no one getting behind the defense to make it an easy throw. But nowadays, it's...
And, oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And a big return will get him all the way down to the 35. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. The Eagles in the victory formation as they take an E. So fly, Eagles, fly. It's a victory for Philadelphia. And they were really helped by their defense, forcing 3 turnovers.
I think what we saw in this one, today's defense. And what I mean by that is in the old days, pitching shutouts was big time. That was paramount. But the big thing was holding people down, holding down their yardage, right? Don't let them throw the ball through the air and gain a lot of... But now, it's about taking the ball away. Taking away possessions, getting the ball back for their offense. They had 3 takeaways in this one, and it led them to victory.
So for Philadelphia, their playoff chances take an uptick as they move to 7-4. And they will hit the road next week for a date with the San Francisco 49ers. Meanwhile, for the Browns, They go down to defeat for just the second time in 11 games so far. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to Houston to take on the Texans. Thanks for tuning in, everybody. Alongside Charles Davis, we thank our entire crew. I'm Brandon Gauden. This is the NFL on EA Sports.
Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play on. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. And I gotta win no matter what, like fourth down, Hail Mary, no punch, like every time I touch down, I gotta stunt. Randy Moss, yeah, my number's going up. What do I need any more for? Check the stats up, you can check the scoreboard. Check the stats, Jay Critch, I'm the QB. Ran it up and then I went and got a new freeze. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star, in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. If you ain't a winner, then don't come round. On my way to another city, it's a touchdown. Under late, yeah, I gotta get it in a rush now. Let them hate, try to knock me down, but we got up now.
say that you ballin', keep it real though. Hey, why I never saw you in the field though? Hey, I make it look easy as a field goal. I've been grinding for a minute and I'm still going. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon. How fit to be the boss? Let me find out. My team ballin', you look like you need a timeout. I'm a star in the clutch, I'ma shine out. Working hard, yeah, I'm back on my grind now. Game on, took a loss, but I stay strong. Super Bowl rings, I just wanna play off. Gotta go hard, I can never play soft. Giant in New York, I run it back like Saquon.